Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. I'm Ashkan from CFD College and I'm so glad that I'm with you in this course. In this series of videos, I'm going to teach you how you can process your CFD results in CFD Post. As you know, CFD Post is one of the ANSYS software or modules that you can use to create different contours, velocity vectors, streamlines, you know, other types of results, other types of results from your simulations. And in this course, we will have up to 20 tutorials about different sections of this valuable software. So before starting the first tutorial, if you are interested in these materials, in for example, CFD, numerical simulations, ANSYS Fluent, SecPlot, ParaView, and so on, do not forget to subscribe the channel so that you don't miss our future videos. And if you find these videos useful, please share these with your friends. And okay, let's jump to the main point. CFD Post, let me open this workbench. If you have worked with CFD with a workbench, ANSYS workbench, you may see this module results. It's available in almost all the analysis systems. This is a Fluent block. Here you can see Polyflow block. I don't know, CFX structural, static structural. In almost all of these analysis systems, you can see these module results. This is CFD Post, a very useful software in ANSYS that you can use to make, you know, precious pictures, contours, and charts from your results. And not only CFD results, you can use CFD Post to show your, for example, structural results or other modal results or any other analysis system you can see here. There are two ways to run CFD Post, to use a CFD Post. The first one is through Workbench. As you can see, you can work with different blocks, different analysis systems, for example, Fluent. And then in the end, after your simulation is finished, you can open the results and work on your you know, visualizations. Here under component systems, you can see CFD Post again, results. As you can see, this is a separate CFD Post. You can link any of these solutions to CFD Post, for example, this one, and see, you can see the results in this lone CFD Post. In one of the tutorials, I will explain you why we have this capability. And the other way, the second way, is to use standalone CFD Post. So after you install ANSYS on your system, you can search it, CFD Post, and you can run it separately. You know, it's not in Workbench, it's a standalone CFD Post. So this CFD Post is opened separately, not through Workbench. So we call this standalone CFD Post. We have standalone Fluent also, and CFX. You don't need to work in Workbench to work with many of the modules in ANSYS. For example, Fluent, CFX, Space Claim, ICM, CFD, CFD Post, and so on. Okay, now it's good to have a look at CFD Post. This is different windows you can see. The largest one is 3D Viewer. You can see it here. First of all, I should say that I think your CFD Post is not similar to mine, because I've made some changes. So, for example, my background is white, and I think your background is a gradient of dark blue to light blue. So, I'll show you how you can change it. I always prefer the white background. So, the largest window is a 3D viewer. We have also table viewer, chart viewer, and report viewer. Here you can choose. We mostly visualize our data, our results here in 3D viewer. And we use chart viewer when we want to generate and create some charts. Top ribbon, we have different menus, actually one-line menus, file, edit, monitor, session, insert, tools, and help. Using file, you can load results, you can load state, or save the state. In future tutorials, you will find out what are these. And import, export, report, and save pictures. In edit, you have the option to undo and redo your movements, your commands. And in option, if you click on the option, you can you have access to different options here. For example, in the viewer section, I changed the color type from top button gradient to solid color, and I chose white color here. So if you wanna have a white background, you can do this. ANSYS logo, you will. I think you have logo of the ANSYS here. You can, remove it. The access visibility and the ruler visibility. Here, if I check it and click on apply, you will see the ruler. And I think this is the most important options that we wanna play with. Here, you can see the units of different parameters, and you can change them. Change the default values if you want. Here in the under the insert tab, you can find different locations. Line, if you wanna create some points, a line, a plane, iso surfaces, iso clips, polylines, and on the others, we will have tutorials for each of these. And here there are some useful commands, for example, velocity vectors, contours, streamline, particle tracking if you have discrete phase, volume rendering to show 3D contours, to add some text, coordinate system, and color bar. And here, to create a new variable, to write expressions, you can use these. Expressions are mainly used in different simulations to get to define new variables, to define some output parameters or something, and you can find chart here. Most of these you can find them in the in this ribbon. As you can see here, we have velocity vectors, contours, streamlines, particle tracking, volume rendering, and others. And the locations can be reached from this icon. Here we have undo and redo, save a picture, and load results, and so on. If you import a transient data, you can access different time steps. If you click on this button, time step selector, you can make animations in steady state or transient simulations using this animation function, animation feature, which is here. And there are some other capabilities that you will be familiar with them. You will become familiar in the next tutorials. Here we have the outline tree, and below we have the details of each of these commands. For example, if I wanna create a contour, the details of the contour will appear here, and you can change them or modify the options details of any commands that you have used so far. And if you add any commands, if you create any locations, charts, or some or others, you will see them here in the outline tree. You will see these options in the next tutorials. We have different tabs here: variables, expressions, calculators. We use a function calculator to calculate. The temperature, different variables. For example, the temperature, pressure, velocity at different boundaries. So these tabs are important too. And I think it's enough for the first tutorial. Now you know how to open and run CFD Post, either using Workbench or in standalone mode, and you all know what these windows are. So far, I think it's okay and it's enough. In the next tutorials, we start to load and import CFD results in CFD Post, and as time passes in different tutorials, we use in each tutorial we use specific commands and we teach them to you. For example, one session will be about contour, for velocity vectors, and so on. Again, if you like these videos, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe the channel so you don't miss our future videos. Hit the notification bell, please, and share these videos with your friends if you find them useful. Thank you for watching this video. Until the next tutorial, take care of yourselves and bye-bye.